Hey guys, it's me, Lilac Rose, and I am back here with a review, not an unboxing, review for this limited edition, beautiful 18-inch doll, Prince Philip from Sleeping Beauty. Yes, I'm so excited to have him. I know I wanted to upload a Disney limited edition doll for so long, and I finally get to. I actually have another one too. If you follow me on Instagram, you know what it is, so follow me on Instagram. Yes, before we get into Prince Philip's review, don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, and ring that bell notification so you are notified every time I upload a video, including anime music videos. I am so happy to have him a part of my collection. I am so grateful. I think he looks stunning. He looks amazing. And I can't wait to get to review him for you guys. So roll that clip so we can get started. We didn't do it for the fame or the glory, but we went down in history. Yeah, we were legends, loving you, baby, it was heaven. Hey guys, so we are back here with Prince Philip, and we have this beautiful, gorgeous box. It's white with kind of like wooden details almost. If you look at it closely enough, it almost looks wooden. We have some golden dragon embroidery around here. Very beautiful, very, very, like, you know, medieval times, like it was designed. I do have Aurora and Maleficent. You guys can check both of them out on the description below. I'll leave in the bottom. This is limited edition Philip, 1 out of 3,500 Prince Philip. So as we turn Prince Philip to the side, we do have this beautiful window of gaze through him. You can see beautiful. It's just, I love the coloring, this brown and like gold. We can see like triangles on the box, really nice. Here is the back. It's a Sleeping Beauty Prince Philip, and it has his crest right here. Gorgeous. And if you guys wanted to read the description, you guys can just pause the video. On the bottom is a certificate of authenticity and display stand. We do have everything on here. No children. It says a Disney logo right here. And its original price was $119, which was really nice. I wish they were still that price. I remember when they were that price. They're not that price anymore. They're about $135, $140. So yeah, they go up in price, and they're like less limited to me, I believe. So here is the beautiful top. What I mean by less limited is that they have less details than what they used to do. Like, look at all this embroidery. It's so beautiful. So let's get inside his box. Get into some review of Prince Philip. I want to show you guys his certificate of authenticity. It says Prince Philip Collector Doll. This limited edition Prince Philip doll release in Disney Store 2014. Wow, that was a while back ago. Has been craftedly designed by character artists to ensure every detail was captured. We hope you enjoy this heirloom doll for years to come. I got 583 out of 3,500. The male dolls are not that much of a higher price or higher manufacturing made like the prints are. I like the male dolls because they're just as important as the princesses. So a lot of people like the princesses because the glitz and glamour and makeup and all that fun stuff. So yes. So here we have Prince Philip. I want to give you guys a little side view and another side view of him. His hair is rooted. I really like that. His hair is all rooted. So yes, you can comb it or do whatever. It does have a whole bunch of hairspray on it, so it is very gelled down. Really nice. I do like his face mold. It doesn't really look like him. Kinda, not really. I do like how he has brown eyes. He does have like a little arch right here. A little bit of like sagginess, like he's tired. He has really light nude lips, not any makeup on, maybe a little bit of tiny blush, but that's about it. Not really a lot. And he does have nice thick eyebrows. As we go down, we can see that he has a very thick neck, and we can see that his head is rotatable. We can unhatch this, but I don't really want to because I did it the first time. As you guys can see, it is a hook. Yeah, I had a hard time trying to unhook it, so let me take him back a little bit. But yeah, you can see that beautiful embroidery all over his, on top of his cape. It's a dragon. Really nice. Really, really beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. I do like how that looks. Beautiful golden embroidery. And as we go down to his chest, we do have some a crest right here with a sword between it. The same thing that's almost on the sword, or the shield and the sword actually. And we do have two dragons right here throwing out flames. Really cute, cool embroidery. I do like how they have abs because I can feel his, like, his six pack. The material is kind of vinyl, so it's not like any stretchy material that you would probably wear out for war. It's probably too hot to wear this, so you probably wear that just in the kingdom. Here we have a puppy sleeve. I remember Snow White having these, and Giselle's husband, that was going to be her husband, has these too, but I don't know what they're called. Yes, we have puppy sleeves that are gold and red with the gold vinyl on it and red, with some gold embroidery. Really pretty, and it goes all the way around, which is really nice. Disney Store really does a nice job when they release Disney Store dolls. And we have like some legging material on here. It hasn't bled on his skin, thank God, because usually they do. As we look into the waist right here, he does have a like fake pleather belt. Really nice. Looks like they cut a strip and they didn't cut really good because I can see some of the cut right here. So yes, it does have some embroidery on it. Very, very nice. I'm not trying to touch his crotch, but yes, I want to lift up his shirt a little bit so you guys can see how many layers are under. Oh, you can see his underwear. He has blue underwear on, same as his pants. So yes, we do have a little bit embroidery right here on the shirt, the bottom of the shirt. Really beautiful gold embroidery. Does it go behind the outfit? Yes, it does. It's behind the outfit as well. Really nice embroidery. The same thing on for the other side. And as we go to his right side, which is your guys' left, we do see he has a long plastic, kind of not too sharp sword. Really nice sculpted. His hand fits in it perfectly. It does have black kind of twist handle. Really nice. I really like that. And on the other side, he has a shield. Really big shield. I really like how the shield looks. Really cool. It has rubber bands. It has little details to it. Are really nice. So it has a big old cross on here and some more details of flames or whatever it might be. I like how it looks like it's been used, so that obviously protects him from Maleficent. You can see that he has the puff sleeve on the other side. Here is his back, because we can't really see his back that much. I don't take my dolls out. I leave them in the box forever and ever. So as we go down, we can see that he has some really nice kind of almost jean almost looking kind of pants. Not so much jean, but the material, but it's definitely stretchier, kind of like polyester. So yes, so here we have his boots. I think that is my favorite part of the doll, where they look kind of dirty, but they're not dirty. They're just like painted on there to make it look like they've been worn out. Really like that. Really nice detail, Disney Store. Really good. I like how it has all the wrinkles in here, and it looks like he's been wearing them for a while. And they are two plastic pieces, so they have a slit down in the middle like every doll shoes do. They have boots. We have his beautiful cape. His cape is just amazing. I really like how it has like this Velcro kind of like felt almost finish. And then in the back here, it has like a silk. Really nice. I like it. It's two pieces and it's sewed together holding by this beautiful thin golden lining. The same thing for the other side. It does feel kind of heavy. I'm not going to lie. I really like the quality of this cape. I think Disney Store does amazing capes when they come with their dolls. I think the best cape that they did was Snow White's, when it had all that beautiful detail on it and pearls on it. I think they did an amazing job. The very, very first Snow White. I wish I had that one. I really do. So here we have his background. It has, I was about to say Cinderella's. It has Sleeping Beauty's castle, but is taken over by Maleficent. You guys can see some of the evil, you know, thorns in the background. Really cool. I really do like how this looks. You can see some stone wall and some plants on the bottom, and he's just ready for a war. I am ready for a war. The girls want a battle. Yes, I listen to their podcast. I love it. Shout out to Licious. So yes, Wow, the stone on the background looks really cool, the stone wall. I really like how it has all the bricks, and then you can see the different parts of the castle. It's giving me kind of mixture of Beauty and the Beast's castle and Cinderella's castle more than, I guess the angle that they have it at is just giving me more of that than Sleeping Beauty's. So yeah, that is my little Prince Philip kind of review. I don't really unbox my dolls. I wish I can show you what they look like behind, but I don't unbox them. So let me put him back in the box. Alright guys, so I am back here with my fully review of Prince Philip 17 inch limited edition doll from the Disney store. You can no longer pick him up at the Disney store, sadly. You can only get him third hand party. He's not that expensive, so if you really want him, pick him up. I really want him because I wanted him to go with my Aurora doll. I do have Aurora, I do have Maleficent. I am so happy I got them. So yeah, if you want to see my Aurora unboxing or my Maleficent, they will be in the description bottom below. So don't forget to give that a like as well and comment and see if you like it. And I will be giving you guys more Disney limited edition dolls. They're a little bit harder to get than skateboards and anime because they're not as expensive. Especially the female dolls can be really, really expensive. Yeah, that's why I got a male. So I was like, is this all I could afford? At least I'm giving you guys something. I wanted to show you guys a beautiful doll. So thank you guys. Oh, you guys can see Shishomaru. I'm watching Inuyasha. So yeah, it's just wow. I love the detail in this doll. I think it's amazing. The Disney store did an amazing job from head to toe. So I'm just giving you guys a glimpse of what he looks like. It's very beautiful. Thank you guys so much for joining me on my channel today for my review of Prince Philip. I am so happy to have him a part of my collection. And follow me on Instagram and Twitter at LilacRose1990, where I'll be posting more photos of him, Maleficent, and Aurora together. So thank you guys so much, and I will see you guys on the next one. Ciao!